This is actually happening. This is not Mordekaiser. Don't get scared. This is not Mordekaiser. All right? That's just a sketch. Don't worry. All right. All right. This is not a drill. It's happening.
Before we even start a project, we look at what exists and try to distill what about it do we want to keep.
I think for the players that main him, they still love Mordekaiser, right? Mordekaiser is iconic to the game.
He's like a walking fortress.
Unstoppable wall of metal.
People. He
it's
is.
The fantasy of being this sort of Lord of Death.
Uh-huh. From a visual standpoint and the gameplay, I think there's a disconnect. Like, you see the splash, you kind of think you know what his play style is going to be.
And then in game, wait, am I a mage? Do I even use my mace?
That's right.
And so...
Chill out! What the... Thank you for dropping out of nowhere your 10 subs. There's no lag. No lag. I can see it, you liar. I don't think anyway. I should be a lag. I could see it. If there was one. Hold on. I need to pimp myself because of you. There's my pimpage. There we go. It feels better. There we go. Thank you. I really appreciate it, by the way. You are an insane person. Thank you so much. You have no idea. No idea. Now. Let's keep going with the video. Everyone is waiting for it.
BGU, we really wanted to approach. How do we make sure that through line is clean all the way while keeping at least the feelings and the element?
That's a guitar. Should I do? No, hold on. You can't see everything that way.
And the things that those old players did like about the champion and bringing them forward.
So, when we pick a champion that we're ready to do a VGU on, we assemble a team that's a designer, a writer, or narrative, and an artist that we call DNA. The DNA pod sits down and talks about, like, how do we take the old Pizza Feet Mordekaiser and make...
I like how Riot is using the still from LOL Wiki. This image is actually... Someone on LOL Wiki had to start a model, some of their model viewers, so they could see the model and take a screenshot of it and got around it. And Riot is using the exact image that technically LOL Wiki took.
And it talks about, like, how do
just
we take
a fun detail, I recognize this exact one.
And make him look like a modern champion, but still immediately recognizable as Mordekaiser.
Whoa!
We really focus on the fact that...
That one was so cool! I know I'm pausing, but I'm sorry, but that is so awesome.
We really wanted to focus on the fact that he is this indomitable warlord.
I have hopes that at the end there will be Mordekaiser in game. I have hopes that it will be revealed.
This was sort of an earlier stage. Just trying to figure out the shape of Mordekaiser, what was the key visual motifs. And that's where we came up with the idea of making it like architecture.
Oh.
We looked at his entire kit very, very closely to see if there's anything we should bring forward, like the ultimate.
Oh, that felt juicy, that one.
Old ultimate was he would kind of put a debuff on a target, and if the target died while that debuff was on them, then Mordekaiser kind of captured their ghost.
He basically becomes a two-man army at that point. And though that is cool, it doesn't really fit with what somebody with a big mace wants to do. It still takes away from the thing that you want to do with him, which is to dominate people with Mordekaiser, not have Mordekaiser
that
command
is
someone
right.
else to dominate.
I know that's the main problem they always had with Mordekaiser, is that they wanted Mordekaiser to be this massive juggernaut that was alone destroying everyone. But they turned him into a team guy.
We did try to bring the ghost forward, and by try I mean we had it in for months and months. And at the end of the day, what we found was that the experience we were creating as a whole was sort of detrimented by having the ghost. So we ultimately decided that while it pained us greatly to remove it, that it would be better for the current kit to just not have that brought forward.
Overall, we wanted to...
Wow, those animations are...
Like the core of what we believe Mordekaiser to have been all along, which is this like death archon.
In this particular case, I think you could represent Lord of Death anywhere on the kit, but the obvious spot to attack from is.
I think it's because he's too small.
So it's with.
I think Mordekaiser is too small. That's my.
Create this story in League of Legends in a matter of seconds.
So Mordekaiser's current background, Mordekaiser is interested in seizing the souls of the living to help him build the afterlife that he was denied. So he's constructing his own death realm.
In terms of gameplay, Mordekaiser can choose a victim to bring with him to...
Is he gonna rip someone's soul and then they will duel in the freaking Shadow Realm? Is that what this is? Because this is a technology that is changing the dial of the ground. Is that what's happening?
In terms of gameplay, Mordekaiser can choose a victim to bring with him to the Death Realm, and they are cut off from their teammates completely.
Oh!
Death Realm is just another interaction layer of the game. So I can't see anybody in the Summoner's Rift layer.
Oh, that is good.
And no one in the Summoner's Rift layer can see me in the Death Realm layer. So now all of the things about using my teammates, getting knockups or heals or stuns or all that stuff is gone.
That is bloody awesome.
Mordekaiser versus me.
But another thing we wanted to keep in mind too is the opponent side of it. We didn't want this spell to just feel like a death sentence of Mordekaiser casts this on me, I just actually die and there's nothing I can do about it, which is why there's still a fight. There's really cool plays of flashing over a wall to get away from him, or
that is cool.
If you are really crafty, kind of outsmart him, and having that goal can allow the enemies who get pulled into the Death Realm to still have a fighting chance against him.
I mean, the only way how this would be imbalanced is that if Mordekaiser was so far ahead, he could go 1v1 against anyone. And I hope he's not designed to be purely 1v1 Juggernaut. Because in that way...
I feel like with the update, this is a great opportunity for us to sort of reintroduce League of Legends players to Mordekaiser.
And for the players out there who really, really like old Mordekaiser, my hope is that we have considered those players as much as we can, and that we have brought forward the best version of the champion that we can deliver to as many players as want to play it, like feeling like they get to be this Death Lord Juggernaut.
The power of the mace smashing their opponent, and then the ability with that ultimate to say to your opponent, there is no escape from Mordekaiser.
Oh, that's so badass! I have one issue with him. First of all, this is brutally awesome. I have one issue with him. I really, really don't like the walk animation. I really don't like the way he walks.
Allow the enemies to get pulled into...
It's not... It doesn't feel like... It's because he's bouncing, I think. It's because... Hold on. Can I find a clip where he's walking? When he's walking and when his animations are moving... His armor is like kind of like fluent on him, and that does not give you the vibe of like metal and iron and like something that's like rock hard. You know?
What we believe Mordekaiser to have been all along, which is this like death archon.
It's too fluid, I would say. Maybe that's...
In this particular case, I think you could represent...
I love everything about him. I don't like his animations. At the end, there was a walk animation. Hold on, was there? Okay, let's see. Let's see here. Hold on. There was a fight here.
The best version of the champion that we can deliver to as many players as want to play it, like feeling like they get to.
Because every step should be a stomp, right? And it should like with every step kind of like fall on the ground.
Be this Death Lord Juggernaut.
To give him
the
weight.
Power of the mace.
Right. Hold on.
Smashing their opponent, and then the ability with that ultimate to say to your opponent, there is no escape from Mordekaiser.
I feel like Sion does better job at kind of portraying that like unbreakable kind of fortress that's coming after you, right? Look at his smile! He's so happy about the rework. It is a really good rework though. But that's my only issue. My only issue is the animation.